Hi dear, in this video I would present the volume Eleonora Duse and Cenere, Ashes, Centennial Essays, published by Macfarlane & Company in 2017. I am the editor with Professor Paul Fryer, director of the Stanislavski Research Center and editor-in-chief of the academic journal Stanislavski Studies. The publication of this volume marks the centenary of the film Cenere, from a novel by Grazia Deledda. It brings together, for the first time in English, a broad survey of scholarship surrounding Duse's only film performance, seen within the creative, political and historical context of its time. After 100 years, the anniversary of Cenere is also linked to the 19th anniversary of the award of the Nobel Prize for Literature to Grazia Deledda, who is still the only Italian woman to have won it. With the generous permission of the Nobel Foundation, we have also been able to include an important item for the significance of Duse and Cenere, the text of the speech given by the president of the Nobel Foundation in December 1927. The practice of filming great actors in representative role is almost as old as the movie picture industry itself. Many star performers also made gramophone recordings of their voices, but in the case of the iconic Italian actress Eleonora Duse, we have no audio evidence of her voice. Our evidence survives in a single film, Cenere, made for the Ambrosio Company in 1916 and released in March 1917. The genesis, the development and the difficulties involved in the make of Cenere are evident in many of the essays of this collection. Duse's perfectionism was too advanced for the rules of the Italian movie industry of the period. She played a leading part in the choice of the subject, in the writing of the script, in the production work on the set, in the final cutting and editing of the film. In this collection, we render historical justice to the many facets of her work and not only as an actress. Moreover, we illustrate Duse's deep involvement in the project and her broader opinion of the silent movie industry in wartime Italy. Cenere offers us the best possible proof of Duse's spiritual meditation as an actress. On the screen, she remembered all the mother rules that she had created for the theater and used them to create a new performance for a new medium. Duse's acting emphasizes the character of Rosalia as an elderly mother, and one who committed a sin because she is a woman who abandoned her son in childhood in order to escape with her lover. But the consequences are too heavy for her, and the final sacrifice of her life becomes a sort of late reparation for her contact of the gift of motherhood. In the volume, you can also find a chapter on Duse's influence within the development of realistic acting, and specifically in relation to the emergence of Stanislavski's system of acting. A chapter with the portrait of the actor Febo Mari, who plays the role of Anania, Duse's son. And also a chapter with the analysis of the correspondence between Duse and her daughter Enrichetta, revealing the view of her potential new career as a movie star. Recording Duse on film was not a simple task, far less simple than taking a photograph. Realizing the many contrasting motivations and emotions of the Deledda's characters is very difficult in the medium of a silent film. We are unable to hear Rosalia's cries of desperation. The physicality and personality of Duse's acting had to compensate for the absence of the technical reproduction of the human voice. For the actress, silence and sorrow are two faces of the same character, Rosalia. If we consider Cenere with the contemporary sensitivity of the second millennium, we quickly realize that this film clearly illustrates Duse's courage to be revolutionary, even at this later phase of her career. Duse was an exceptional artist who left an indelible impression upon the memory of people all over the world. Right up to the end of her career, those who had the good fortune to hear Duse's voice on the stage were enchanted by it. Now, in the second millennium, what remains as our good fortune is the opportunity to observe her living performance in Cenere. Her face has no age, and her legacy is eternal. Thank you. Thank you.